Hey guys, welcome back to another video. This is Gabe with Indigo Software, genuine Microsoft software for less. I became CompTIA A+ certified a little over a year ago, and in this video, I'm going to be sharing what I would do differently throughout that certification process. This video is intended to help you make an informed decision about what is the best way to study and prepare for your CompTIA A+ exam. I am simply sharing my experiences, so please do thorough research before coming to any conclusions. Before we get started with the video, if you guys are interested in purchasing Microsoft Office, remote desktop licenses, Windows 10, Windows 11, or a wide variety of other Microsoft software at a great price, check out Indigo Software. We'll put links down below. So without further ado, let's jump in. Okay, so we'll start off with just giving you guys a little bit of background. I became A+ certified primarily to have a general information technology understanding to help me better teach videos on this channel. In a lot of cases, A+ is considered an entry-level certification that can help you get help desk or similar positions at various companies. Given that this is designed for a sort of help desk or customer service role, a lot of preparing and passing the exam has to do with real-world scenarios, and they're trying to see how you would approach a topic and whether you would handle it correctly or incorrectly. So I actually took a class directly through CompTIA. This was a virtual class with a professor or with an instructor. And at the end of this class, I was given various study guides and resources to sort of continue practicing and continue studying for the exam. And then it was up to me to book the exam. When I purchased the class, I also got the exam vouchers. You have to purchase a voucher for both the core one of the exam and core two of the exam, and you have to pass both in order to get your certification. You can take these exams as many times as you would like, but the vouchers can be a little expensive, and so it's definitely worth trying to pass them on your first go. So I think the first thing that I would have done differently is I would have liked to have had more hands-on experience. This is something that my professor actually recommended to the whole class pretty early on. So what do I mean by this? Well, I haven't actually had any hands-on hardware experience with computers until we built the PC for the channel, which was well after I've earned my certification. I think had I done a PC rebuild or something like that, I would have had a much better understanding of what PC hardware is and how it works and how all of that interacts. Without actually physically being involved with it, it's a little bit hard to understand, in my experience. Our professor had recommended to us to get a for parts PC on eBay or something like that, or find something old at a pawn shop, something with, you know, a CPU and some RAM sticks, tear it apart, rebuild it, learn about the machine hands-on. So I think that's the first thing I would have done differently. As so much of the course is based around computer hardware and peripherals, I think actually being hands-on with that would have helped that learning process. I think the next thing I would have done differently is I would have done more labs. So a huge part of both parts of the exam are what's called performance-based questions. They basically put you in the scenario of an IT technician and they say, hey, here is this problem with this computer. What are you going to do about it? What's your first step and what's the solution? And basically you have to go through the steps and solve the problem. And so I didn't really practice labs very much outside of what we did like in session. And so I think, especially if you're not taking a class, I think it would be very helpful to just practice these labs where you are the technician and you learn what the correct steps are. In the learning material, you're provided with specific steps in a specific order. And so actually putting those to practical use would be really helpful. The next thing I would have done differently is I would have changed my approach in terms of memorization. So one thing I noticed in the CompTIA A+ course material is that there are a lot of specific numbers that you have to memorize. These are things like port numbers. You've got numbers that correspond to networks. And there's just a lot of things that you have to memorize. And when I took the test, I probably got maybe 10 questions wrong. And just simply knowing the number would have been enough to get that point on the test. And so I think it's very valuable to sort of go through and practice that memorization again. And I think maybe flashcards or something like that would be pretty valuable. Now, I do think that had I not taken the actual class and just done a self-study guide, it's definitely possible to pass the test that way, and I think it's possible to learn well that way. But the main benefit to the course is that all of the material was packaged very nicely, and I had set times to attend class, and so it just helped a lot with the discipline, organization, and efficiency of learning all of the material. So I think either way is completely fine. If you're doing a self-learning textbook or just watching a lot of YouTube videos, I think a lot of the principles are the same. And it would just come down to making sure that you're covering enough of the material and hopefully getting some hands-on work experience. All right, guys, that's going to do it for today's video. If you have any questions about the CompTIA A+ exam, or if you want to see more specific video titles around this, drop those in the comment section below. Again, if you're interested in purchasing genuine Microsoft software at a great price, check out Indigo Software. We'll put links down below. Lastly, a like and subscribe would be greatly appreciated as it helps to support the channel. Thanks again for watching. We'll see you guys in the next one.